Hi everyone. In this video, we are going to discuss how to write a Python program to print a multiplication table for a number entered by the user. Usually how the multiplication tables are printed, we know the format, right? So it is usually 1 into, for example, let me assume that I am printing the multiplication table of 2. So 1 into 2. So 1 into 2 equal to 2. So this is what the regular format of printing the multiplication table. So the 2, let me assume that it is the number for which I am printing the multiplication table. I am considering that as the multiplicand, and this 1 is the multiplier. So what will happen is every time I will multiply this multiplicand 2 by a new multiplier. For example, next multiplier is just 1 added to the previous multiplier. So 2 then into 2 equal to 4. So multiplicand is fixed and multiplier is incrementing from one to next. Now how to print a multiplication table in this format? So that's what we are going to discuss in this program. Let me assume that I am going to get the number for which the multiplication table is going to be printed as input from the user. So let me use the input function input enter the number for the multiplication table. So the number for which I am printing the multiplication table is accepted as input from the user, but since it is a string, okay, it cannot be used as an integer. So what I do is I am passing this string as input or parameter to this integer function that is going to convert the string into integer. Now let me store that into a variable m. So this m is going to be used as the multiplicand in our process. So multiplicand is going to be fixed. So every time this multiplicand is going to be multiplied by a multiplier. Now next one is up to which range this multiplication table is to be printed, whether it is from 1 to 10 or 1 to 15 or 1 to 20, right? So up to which range or up to which number this multiplication table is to be printed. So that is to be accepted as input from the user. So let me get that as input from the user. So enter the maximum range of the table. That means up to what number this table is to be printed. Okay. So whether it is from, it's fixed that it is from 1, but the other end is it may be 10 or 20 or 15 or 30 or 100, up to which range this multiplication table is to be printed. That is to be accepted as input. Now let us convert that into integer by using an int function. Now we are storing it into a variable. For example, let me assume that it is n. So here this n is the maximum multiplier that is going to be used in this multiplication table. So the minimum multiplier is 1 and the maximum multiplier is n, right? And from 1 till n, this multiplication table will be printed. So 1 into 2, for example, 1 into 2, then 2 into 2, 3 into 2, up to n into 2, right? So this is how we are going to use this n in our program. Now let us start writing the loop. We have to use a loop since we are going to repeatedly do the multiplication and printing the multiplication table. So what loop is most suitable for this application, not processes? Actually for loop, because for loop is the loop which is meant for a situation when the number of iterations is known in prior. So here, the number of iterations is denoted by the multiplier from 1 till the value n. So already it is clearly defined that this particular for loop is going to be executed for n number of times. So for loop is suited for it, right? Let me write the for loop for, then for loop requires an iterating variable. Okay. Here, this iterating variable is going to be a variable or a value that is going to change from 1 till n. What is that? It is multiplier. So here we are going to manipulate the multiplier, or we are going to update the multiplier from 1 till n, because multiplicand is fixed. It's always, for example, if you are going to find them, print the multiplication table of 2, it is always 2. That multiplicand is always 2. But multiplier should start from 1 and it has to go till n. So let me have an iterating variable I, and in We are going to generate the multipliers. We are going to generate the multipliers within the range from 1 to n. In that case, I can use the range function, range of 1. Then the first multiplier is 1. And what is the last multiplier? N. But if you provide n directly here, then what will happen is it will take only up to n minus 1. If you want the multiplier up to 20, it will take only up to 19. So in that case, have to take up to n plus 1. Now the colon is entered. Now what I do is I want to print the multiplication table in the given format. So let me print. Here I am going to use format method. Here I am going to use the format method or format function, which is going to format the given string in the required format, right? So here what I do is I will have a string. What is that string I want to print in the output screen? 1 into 2 equal to. That means the multiplier into multiplicand equal to. So what I do is I give a placeholder for the multiplier first, then into, then a place for the multiplicand, then equal to, then the product of multiplier and multiplicand. So the placeholder for the product. See, I'm going to use the format method, and the format method is actually providing a way of describing your values to be printed on the screen in the form of placeholders. So placeholders are the places for the variables that are going to replace, or the values of the variables that are going to replace in the string. So here this is for multiplier, and this is for multiplicand, and this is for the product. Now dot format of the first placeholder is for the variable I, that means the multiplier. Second one is for the multiplicand, that is m. And last one is the product of I and m, right? So now this is how the format is working, and now print is finished. Let us run the code. Yes, enter the number for the multiplication table. For example, I want to print the multiplication table of 6. Let me give 6. Now, enter the maximum range of the table. That means from 1 till up to what number I want to print. For example, let me assume that I want to print up to 20. Now, let me give 20. You see, it is printing the multiplication table from 1 into 6 equal to 6 till 20 into 6, that is 120. So this is the program to print the multiplication table using Python. Especially we use this format method or format function to print this string in the output screen in a good way or good looking way, right? So I hope that you understood this program. And a lot of such problem-based videos or the videos to solve the problems are line up in this channel, right? So keep on watching videos, and happy programming. Thank you.